Hi all, this is the Makehaven badging video for the pneumatic hand tools in the metal shop. So they all live right here, and we're just gonna go from top to bottom, and this video is gonna cover all of them. And I'll separate them out in the video so you can click through if you wanna go to a specific tool. So starting at the top, this is an impact wrench. So this is when you want to apply a whole lot of torque to something. And all these tools are pneumatic powered, which means they're powered by compressed air. In the back of the shop, we have a big air compressor that pumps air through pneumatic copper lines all the way through the building. And you connect to them at various points using these hoses. So you just have to turn on the ball valve, which I'll show you in a minute, and then connect using these quick connect fittings. So these quick connect fittings, this is just an air gun, work just like this. So you, when you're trying to remove a tool, you push on the tool, pull back this collar, and it releases. Some of them, like this one, this collar stays pulled back, so all you need to do to put a tool on is push. Some others, you need to manually pull this collar, the sleeve back, and push at the same time. So that's a little bit trickier. The air here is not oiled. It's dry, clean air. So that means for a lot of, well, all of these pneumatic tools, every time you use it, at least once a day, you want to put a drop or two of oil into the air inlet right here so that the machine is oiled. What's nice about these tools is they don't have batteries that'll die. They don't have, other lots of moving parts and motors. They're fairly simple machines, so they can be really durable, which is good and quite powerful. So I'll show you what the ball valves look like on the wall at various places where you might connect to them. So this is one example of the ball valve. And so when a ball valve is perpendicular to the line that it's in, the air cannot flow. And then you turn it to be in line, and now the air can flow. And then sometimes there will be regulators and filters after it. So here's an example of a filter filtering out water and oil from the air to make sure it's extra clean. So just gonna turn this one off. The pressure regulators change the amount of pressure going to the tool. So if you want less pressure going to a tool, you need to put it on one with a regulator so you can change it. The pressure here sits at about 100, 110 PSI. So we're gonna take off this air gun and we're gonna start with the impact hammer. So we're gonna start by putting just a drop of oil in the top. Here's our pneumatic tool oil. And just putting a drop right down the end. Closing this back up. And this again is for if you wanted to put, take a nut or bolt on or off and really powerfully, this would be a good tool. On the side is where you control the direction. So right now it's fully in reverse mode. And then as you move this, it changes direction to go the other way. So this just slides up and forth, so you have sort of a continuously variable amount of movement, and on the back is how you control how much force, how much air is going through. So you can put it all the way lower, and it's less powerful than all the way up, which is going a lot faster. So that's how the impact wrench works. There are impact specific sockets that you want to put on this, so they're in the bottom drawer of the red tool chest. So the impact sockets live right down here, the black ones, and they can handle, they have thicker walls. So these have relatively thin walls. These have much thicker walls, so they can handle the force of the impact from the powerful wrench. And then to take it off, and that's pretty much all there is to it. It's a very powerful tool, so you need to make sure the thing that you're wrenching on is not gonna move. And it can be pretty loud, so hearing protection for many of these pneumatic tools is a pretty good idea. This is a pneumatic sander. So you can get sanding discs that go on here, connects and disconnects the same way. Here's how you control how much air goes through, which is how fast it spins. So you can put buffing pads. There's also another size disc here. And then for this one, it just has a little pin wrench or pin, so it goes in here, and that makes it easier. So then you put a screwdriver on here to tighten down on that. That's just how you hold on to this so you can tighten it up. Then here we have our cutoff wheels. So these have these abrasive wheels on them. These are fairly dangerous because they can explode. which is why there's this guard around it. So a face shield isn't a bad idea when you're using it. And if this is getting small, you want to make sure to replace it. If there are any cracks or this is looking frayed, then throw it out. It is too dangerous to use. All of these are pretty high speed. So you need to bear that in mind. This isn't like a high torque tool, it's a high speed tool. So you're going to be probably cutting thinner stuff with it. You need to make sure that the tool that you put in is rated to 18,000 RPM. So just make sure to check that when you put a wheel in. And then on this one, you would just hold the bottom with a wrench and put an Allen key in the top. And that's how you would release the disc. And it looks like this takes 3-inch discs. So if you're going to go out and buy more, you want 3-inch ones. The accessories for these tools, if they're not in the bin because they're specific to the tool, live down in here. So there are various kinds of wrenches and accessories that live down in that bin. This tool is called a nibbler. So it's a pretty cool tool. It has this little pin down in here and a die, and it just moves up and down. And in doing that, can cut metal. So you can do curves in metal, you can cut sheet metal. So the nibbler can be used on sheet metal up to 16 gauge, which is a 16th of an inch. So here's some sheet metal, and we're going to connect it to air and just do a curve to show you how it works. It cuts out little crescent shapes. So we're going to just connect it to the air like normal, except we're going to put the oil in first. And eventually the little cutter in the tip will get dull, so you'll have to replace that. And this goes on here. And I'm just going to wear a glove because the sheet metal can be sharp. All right. So just like that, you can make pretty cool cuts in sheet metal. So that's pretty great tool, I would say. It can't do like sharp 90 degree turns, but for curves and some straight lines, it's pretty good. And 16 gauge is fairly thick metal. Disconnect this. The collar on this was stuck in the down position, and so it was still releasing air. So what you need to do is just pull back on the collar to get it back into the closed position, just so you know. Right. So now this is just a right-handed or right-angle drill. So again, we're just going to put a drop of oil in. And this is just a fairly normal drill, but it can get into tight little spaces. So if you're trying to get somewhere that's hard to get to otherwise, it has a normal key. There's a keyed chuck that used to tighten the drill bit. It only goes forwards. It doesn't have reverse. So it's mostly for drilling holes, probably. Works just like that. That's a pretty straightforward tool. Then these are die grinders. So they right now have a 1/4-inch collet in them. So a collet is like the chuck that we were just looking at, except that it pinches down only on one size. So in this case, it's a 1/4-inch. You can change the size collet. There are wrenches in the bin that you put on here and on here to loosen up on the collet so that you can take out, in this case, a totally used up wire brush. And a die grinder is similar to a Dremel, just lower speed and higher torque. So you can use it for brushing things, for you could put a burr on the end for grinding on something, you use a grinding end for deburring. So there are all kinds of uses for a die grinder. There are some accessories in there, and you can obviously get others. You can put sanding pads on there. And then these are just right angle die grinders. So this is similar to a normal angle grinder, which is like an electric tool that you use, but it's just smaller and less powerful. So this could be good for getting into little places and grinding away at things. And it's the same as the die grinder, just at a right angle. This is a pneumatic impact hammer. And or just air hammer. It's just just a hammer. So what you do is you can put a tip in it, like this one. So there's this big spring. Take off the glove. So you pull back this part of the spring and drop your tool in, like that. And then it's just a hammer, and this just smashes forward and backwards. So this tip could be used for cutting the head of a nail off, has that little notch there for sitting under a nail head. If you know, going into concrete or something, you can use it to smash stone, concrete, other hard things. There are a whole bunch of tips here for various purposes, but it's effectively just like a really powerful hammer for smashing things. So that's a pretty cool tool. Again, the speed control is down on the bottom, and the tip comes out like that. This is a little jigsaw type tool, except obviously pneumatic powered. And some of these tools have these safety, so you just need to push this forward to go down. So if you're just holding it, you can't accidentally squeeze this. You have to push this forward to get it to go in. This is good, again, for sheet metal. So you wouldn't be cutting thick chunks of metal with this. There are different kinds of blades in there, some with more teeth, some with fewer teeth. So you have more teeth for things that are softer. I'm sorry, you have more teeth per inch for things that are harder, and then fewer teeth per inch and bigger teeth for things that are softer. And this, you know, I would say is really just for sheet metal. You can do interesting curves, and you want to keep your material pushed right up against the edge here. So you would clamp this, and then you could cut right along with the material pushed right up against the edge. This is a pretty nifty tool. And last but not least, these are shears. So they're like scissors that just move up and down by a little bit right there. And these are only okay to use up to 20 gauge. So 20 gauge is counterintuitively thinner than 16 gauge. So these can't do quite as thick metal, but these can be good for straight lines or really soft curves when you're trying to cut sheet metal. And then down here are some accessories, like I mentioned, some buffing wheels and wire wheels, and you're welcome to get more. And if you're hooking up to an airline that had a ball valve on it, just make sure to turn that off so we're not just slowly leaking out the air. And as with all tools, when you're done, just make sure to clean up. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching.